one of the picketers, after shedding his sign, nightly went inside to buy his paper. From 37,000 over-the-counter sales on the first day of the strike, sales zoomed to 915,000 on the last day, of which 584,000 sales were made over-the-counter to individuals in the lines you see. Happily, however, even labor strike has its lighter moment. By courtesy of Movietone News, Mayor F.H. LaGuardia reads the comics.
Here's Dick Tracy. Now here, the first picture is the laundry wagon. It's a yellow laundry wagon. And wet wash, that's the driver, you know. He's very calmly sitting down with his back toward the back of the wagon, eating his lunch. Our little friend, Bleeding Heart, what is her name? I'll give it in a minute. She's inside with the money. And she says,
"When are you going to let me out of here?" He says, wet wash says, "Easy, sister, easy." And then the next picture, and we hear the sound from inside the wagon. Wet wash says, "I'll let you out when you decided to give me a better cut of that dough." From the inside, and we see the inside now. "I offered you $1,000. What do you think I am? This is my money." And if you remember, she starts stripping and tearing up the laundry. And she has all of the money in bills in a pillow slip. And we hear wet wash, "Listen, baby, I know you're a maid at Van Hoosen's. I saw you there last week. And I know there's something phony about that dough. Now, when we get it, it's going to be 50-50. Okay, then maybe you'd like some more of your laundry torn to pieces." Rip! She's ripping her laundry there, and that little delicate piece of lingerie. And he looks in. "Ye gods, I lose my job over this. Stop, you win. I'll settle for $5,000. Now, get this picture. Here is wet wash. The doors of the laundry wagon are open. He's leaning with his back toward the wagon, and he's counting his money. 2, 3, 4,000. Now he's getting into the hundreds. 600, 700, 800. And the picture shows a hand of breathless stretching out. She's got hold of that iron pot. Remember the iron pot she took from the Van Hoosen's gardener's flat to put the money in. And crash! She crashes it on his head. Knocked out.
Say, children, what does it all mean?
It means that dirty money never brings any luck.
Thus, New York learned that if the newspapers could not go to the public would come to the papers. During the 17 days of the strike, the public came to the various plants, bought a total of 10,628,000 newspapers. Trouble, inconvenience, this was the price paid each day for New York newspapers by long lines of people in rain and sun, standing for hours on hard concrete, risking bodily harm by cutting through picket lines, impervious to shouted warnings of pickets in a city heavily unionized. Men, women, and children in all walks of life, giving up a summer evening of pleasure or relaxation, going without lunch or postponing dinner for hours, coming for miles in oven-warm subways to stand for long periods in halting or slow-moving files. Patient, perspiring, persistent, all for a few penny purchase. Such is the miracle of journalism. And such is the significance of newspapers to their readers. Newspapers which can be read and reread. Newspapers in which the public can read all about it in their own time, at their own convenience. And thus was New York's sigh of relief when the strike finally was ended, when within the hour the trucks were rolling and New York life returned to normal. Once again, dramatic proof has been given that no other medium can take the place of newspapers in the lives of the people. And the fundamental reason why newspapers are held in such high regard by the American public lies in that long-cherished bulwark of liberty, freedom of the press.